This video shows how to set up and configure a MID server. The MID server enables ServiceNow applications to communicate with external systems on the enterprise's local network or in the public cloud. The ITOM guided setup steps you through the process of installing a MID server and getting it ready to use. A MID server can be installed on a Windows or Linux host, either on the enterprise's network or in the cloud, like an Amazon Web Services EC2 instance running in a VPC. You'll need to use a Windows host to discover Windows machines, so that's what we'll use here. For more information on requirements for the host server, search for MID Server System Requirements in the product documentation. We're working at our desktop machine, connected to the MID Server host through the Microsoft Remote Desktop Client. Here we're in a local browser, logged into our instance as admin. To start the setup, we'll go to ITOM Guided Setup and get started. Guided Setup can help you set up several ITOM apps. For this demo, we'll go straight to the MID Server setup. The first task is to create a user account for the MID Server in the ServiceNow system with the MID Server role, which provides access to the resources it needs. The system defines all that for us. All we have to do is enter the username and password. There, the user account was created, so this task is complete. The next task is to download and install the MID Server software. Since we need to install it on the host machine, we'll switch over to the host on the remote desktop. We're logged into the same instance as admin. We'll go to ITOM Guided Setup and continue. And now we're right where we were in the local browser. To install the software, we'll click Configure and choose the host's operating system. Downloading the file may take a few minutes. When the download is complete, we'll move it to a folder we've created for the MID Server files. Next, we'll extract the MID Server files to the MID Server demo folder. When that's done, the files are in the agent folder. To install the MID Server, we'll run the installer batch file. We'll specify our instance and the MID Server username and password we defined in the previous configuration step. Next, we'll test our connection and continue. We'll call our MID Server Demo MID Server 4, and we'll use the supplied value for the other fields. The configuration summary looks correct, so we'll save. Finally, we'll start the MID Server. That completes the installation, so we'll mark this step complete. That's all we need to do on the host, so we'll switch back to the local browser. We'll reload the page, and now the install task appears as complete. The next task is to validate the new MID server. This security feature ensures that only those MID servers that are validated by the instance can communicate with the instance. We'll click Configure, and here's our new MID server. We can see it's up and running. We'll open the form for the MID server and validate. This setting specifies which ServiceNow applications can use this MID server. We'll allow all apps to use it. This setting specifies which capabilities this MID server supports, like SNMP, VMware, and PowerShell. We'll say this MID server supports all capabilities. And this setting specifies which IP addresses this MID server can reach on the network. For now, we'll say it can reach all addresses. We'll refine that later in this setup process. Now let's start the validation process. It can take a few minutes. When the MID server is validated, we'll go back to Guided Setup and mark this task as complete. That completes the required MID server setup. You could start using it right now, but we're going to do one more thing. Assign the IP address ranges for the subnetworks that the MID server can connect to. Guided Setup does that automatically by discovering subnets. In order to discover subnets on the network, the MID server needs SNMP credentials to log on to network devices. Be sure this credential has the required permissions as shown in the MID server product documentation. There's a link in the description of this video. We'll click Configure, then Create New Credentials, and choose SNMP Community. We'll type a name for the credentials and a password, an SNMP Community string. We'll use the supplied values for the other fields. If we wanted to restrict the use of this credential to specific MID servers, we'd do that here. We'll submit, and here are the new credentials in the list. That completes this task. Next, we'll let the system automatically assign IP address ranges to the MID server. These are the subnets that the MID server can reach in order to interact with endpoints in those subnets. This process is automated. All you have to do is start it. You can do this assignment for more than one MID server at once. This list shows all the MID servers that are up and validated. For this demo, we're going to use the one we just defined. This form lets you monitor the process. The process can take as long as a few hours, depending on the size of the network. We're going to skip ahead and look at the form when the process is complete. The assignment process has two steps. The first step is to identify the subnets that the MID server can access. To do this, the MID server searches the network for all the routers it can log into using the SNMP credentials we defined in the previous task. Those routers are listed here. The MID server reads the routing table on each router to identify the subnets known to that router. Those subnets are listed here. The second step is to identify which IP address ranges can be reached by the MID server and assign them to the MID server. In this step, the MID server attempts to access each subnet it found. If it succeeds, the IP address range for that subnet is assigned to the MID server. Those address ranges are listed here. Going forward, when an application like discovery or service mapping needs to access a particular target on the network, it chooses a MID server whose assigned ranges include the target's address. If there are any subnets that can't be reached by any MID server, they're listed here. You may want to add another MID server to reach these subnets. That's the end of the IP address assignment process. Let's go back to guided setup and mark that task as complete. And that completes the guided setup. Our MID server is ready to use. Now you can set up applications that use the MID server, like discovery and event management. Later videos in this series will show you how to do it. For more information, please consult our product documentation, knowledge base, or podcast, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.